Ottawa's light rail transit system includes two major stations on these grounds connecting the Breton with points east, west, and south of our capital. It's a great catalyzing project. I don't think we'd be here tonight without the leadership of the City of Ottawa with the transit project. And after decades of incremental progress, we've arrived at this defining moment in the Breton Flats story. And together we can now begin to imagine a new neighborhood on these lands, a landmark district that will shape the city for generations and position our capital as a competitive force in the 21st century. For the NCC, this is a very exciting moment. I launched this initiative shortly after becoming CEO two years ago. 18 months ago, we established this very competitive process to develop up to 20 hectares of this prime land. I'd like to recognize Chairman Russ Mills, who's the chair of the National Capital Commission, who's here tonight. Thank you for coming, Russ.
What you do is go from this, we're going to go into a phase that is going to last for decades. And everybody that's here today, make sure you get yourself a picture, because you'll be able to show this to people decades from now and say, I was actually there. And I actually said something. So for us, it's very, very exciting. This project, just to put it in perspective, is so transformative. If you took this and the plans that both of us have, and plucked it anywhere, any city in the world would welcome it with open arms. It's spectacular. And we hope to be able to show you that today. We have a presentation by our lead architect, and after that we have a little video for you to see, and you can see that on our websites, and hopefully that we impress you that you'll be cheering for us. I went to this team, our internal people, said, you know what, we've got to do something, and the big test is going to be, number one, when somebody walks up, do they say, wow, that's amazing. Are we going to be able to get someone and listen to someone say, yeah, I don't know where I'm going to go on holidays, but I heard this place in Canada is supposed to be special. And also, they say, yeah, that Breton Flats thing. Yes, the Breton Flats thing. Then you want them to say, well, I'm going to go to Canada, and I'm going to go to Ottawa. So they do a whole tour here, and the Breton Flats is what was germinating in their minds to come and see. And they go, wow, that's going to be our litmus test. So, you know, our excitement, you say, well, what are you guys doing inside? Yes, it's a very big project. It's hopefully going to make money one day. But for us, it's transformative. It's something that we can look upon with pride. I think the people of this city will look at it with pride. Bragging rights for everyone here. And at the end, it's just going to be something that you're going to really, really be excited about. You know, it's 53 acres. Think of the size of this thing. And for our team to come up with things that are relevant and meet all the criteria of the N.C.C., and that is that wow factor, it was not easy. We put together a team of international people to design it. From Copenhagen, I didn't do this tour, but Copenhagen, L.A., San Francisco, Toronto, Montreal, Ottawa. All the leadership team on this project is from Ottawa. And it's, again, Mr. Hogan is going to walk you through all of the things that they have done and all their planning, and then at the end I'll come back and wrap things up, and we'll see a little video. All right, with that, I'd like to invite Mr. Hogan to come up with
you. You can see the passion that Eugene has for this project and the importance of the Ottawa Senators. Great that you all come out tonight. It was even more impressive night on cheap movie night, Tuesday night, that we had for us as well. We've been working on this for over a year and a half, and a lot of time has been spent getting to this stage. But in the end, it's the first time you're seeing it. And so it's important to open this up and say, let's have a conversation about what this could be. The Breton Flats is in the very heart of the region, adjacent to the river. It's so important in terms of knitting together both sides of the river, and then reflecting where we are, not only culturally, but historically. They've taken down a lot of the images up in the lobby that referred to Ottawa's history around the river, about how the history informs how we design the future. And so the river, First Nations, lumbering, transportation, potable water, innovation, harnessing the river and electrifying the city, that gentleman, Thomas Ahern, you probably don't know his name. Thomas Ahern is the guy who developed water systems and harnessed the river for power, electrified the city, and actually allowed the streetcar to come to Lansdowne Park. You don't know that. What you don't know as well is that his son was the first owner of the Ottawa Senators. I grew up in Ottawa, the West End. This picture is my memory of the Breton Flats. Saturday morning, my dad used to drive me down to play hockey at the old auditorium. The memorable things are things like the roundhouse at the bottom right, the industrial part of coming up Albert Street with the breweries and the manufacturing, and then to realize that the river was dominated by industry and taken over the public domain, And so by the 60s, just before this is demolished, or you know, throughout progressively through the 1900s up to the 60s, at one point in time there were 7,000 people living on this site. Combination of, it's a 19th century city where you worked, you lived, and you played all in the same space. But what you didn't realize that the river basically came in substantially more. So in the 60s, in the brilliance of modern planning, we took all of that, what would have become our new distillery district, and plowed it into the bay. And to further separate us from the city, we built this parkway along the edge, again, separating the city from the river. In the process of doing that, we did a couple of things. One, we continued a contamination issue, which we still have to deal with, which we are going to do with as part of our presentation. We separated the river by way of a parkway, and we denuded the site of what was there. So moving forward, here's the site today, and Marcus mentioned the readjustment. Along to speak, you can see where the LRT crosses the site now, the future line of it, but you can start to see the Festival Plaza. In looking to the future, what we want to do in creating a new capital is to reintegrate 7,000 people living on this site, correct the major deficiencies that are there, tap into this new infrastructure that's going to be part of the city, the LRT, the largest infrastructure project we've ever taken on to the city, and basically create. So in unpacking all of that, you ask yourself, how do we do that? And it's very clear, the NCC has told us, we want you to create memorable capital moments. We want this to represent the country, not just the city. It's my point that you can't talk about creating a national capital presence unless you're talking honor what's there by way of the template. What was there that actually created the city? The story of Ottawa is very much, and its relationship to the river, is very much the story of major Canadian cities across the country. So when we talk about heritage, I think we have to respect this, the river, where it comes into Nepean Bay. We talk about placemaking, about the canal system that sits there, that is part of that. So the three components that we think are important to this whole project, just in the conversation. One is to bring those attractors that make sense to animate the city and to make it a capital place. To honor those pieces that are there now and build the new capital event out of what's there. And then build, bring in what is important as the animators that will make sense. But above all that is the notion we're designing a 21st century capital city. A city that represents the best thinking about eco-planning, about the one planet initiative. We only have one planet to live with. Where sustainability and fracturing the world that we live in is on everyone's mind right now. We have to be thinking about sustainable in a really conscious way, not just about making buildings more efficient, about our thinking about living in the city. So in doing that, when we come to the site plan that we developed, and you can see in the middle, right, strategically located, is the new event center in between the two transit stations, the major events to the side. In order to make this city porous and accessible for all those neighborhoods to the south and to the west, you have to harness what is the large infrastructure piece that's come along, and that's the LRT. Bottom left, and on the right, that's west and east, you can see the two transit stations. In between them, running above ground, is a transit line. Allowing that to exist as it is actually cuts everything off. You know, if you looked at what's happened in Chicago around Millennial Park, what they created was, by bridging the transit and coming over top of it, they recreated the city. And in this case, our initiative is to build over top the LRT, connect the porousness of the neighborhoods to set it through the existing grid through, and we create a new street. As a result of that, what we call Canada Drive. That creates a new template on the top of that, and then down at the aqueduct level, many people don't even know the aqueduct exists, by the way. The aqueduct, which is in the center of the site, we create these two worlds. Canada Drive will link the eastern Tennessee station all the way to the western Bayview station, and will become a reflection of the Canadian experience, reflecting 12 provinces, 10 provinces, and the territories. So as a result of that fundamental shift, we sort of neutralize the negative impacts of transit and actually turn it into a positive. So you can see now we develop all sorts of mobility around bicycles, pedestrians, cars, O-train, LRT, and what we are great pieces. It's important to recognize that fractioning of the porosity site comes from the neighborhoods to the south of the original Breton grid. You saw those images. And each of those neighborhoods has a different character and actually provides us a variety of house types by way of building form, a variety of occupancies, not only rental, free market rental, not for profit, and free market condo. I'm doing Renee Daoud's presentation tonight, and the other part to our package in between those buildings is the notion of the public realm. Over 50% of our site is dedicated to the public realm, to open space. But we didn't want to create an open suburban park and an edge condition. We actually wanted to take that 50% and create 11 memorable experiences on site that infuse every park and every neighborhood that is part of this project. I want to take a few of those. The very first one that's important to us is that view from the Western Parkway. I talked about the 60 post-war planning of the parkway. We want to fractionalize the parkway and turn it back into more of an urban experience. We want to connect the neighborhood that is adjacent to it to the river. We want to stop seeing the river on this side and the building on that side. We actually want to see those two things move together. So if you look at the building forms, the open space, the pattern of buildings, that we want to actually celebrate that immediate connection to the water. And in the distance, this vista leads you right to Parliament Hill. So we're creating a capital view. It's not a Pennsylvania Avenue divided in the 18th century by some French planner. It's the notion that it's a Canadian experience. That view to Parliament Hill has an edge condition with water and makes you feel like this is a Canadian experience. Moving along, the Place de Lagarde takes you out into the river, and you can see how it creates a promontory. That promontory takes you back into Bayview Park, which centers the western neighborhood, a combination of art and landscaping. Now the view from the east, the green line, which takes us towards the event center, which sees us looking from the east, with a variety of experiences. We felt it was important to pull back the view from St. John A. and open up this green so we could see the Nepean Bay, we could see the event center, and have a greater respect for the capital view to downtown. That starts with the notion of the nation's plaza with the corner, which in a contemporary fashion represents the very visceral elements of water and of fire, and continues on as you step towards the event center. Along that axis is an art axis, so in that space, it's just not leftover space, it's actually structured with outdoor rooms which accommodate art and culture. And then, as we move forward, we've got the innovation promaya, which actually sees these installations that allow us to experience a variety of culture. The end of that is we actually end up to the aqueduct and our view towards the event center. And along that view is the Ability Center, which is part of the Senseplex initiative to reach out to a favorite charity, our favorite training facility that has been built in Whitby. It's for able and disabled athletes, and it becomes a national platform for the training of Paralympics. A big part of that is the library, and we're going to watch our time, but I think we have 5 minutes, but we have 5 minutes after that, so we're... The library is an important part to us. We've involved partners from Copenhagen and Bruce School of Art, a workshop from Copenhagen and Bruce School of Art from Toronto, to define the library. They both felt it was essential that the library be on the canal, connected to the aqueduct, and actually animate the public space as well. The aqueduct is the big part of it. I'm going to move through this very quickly, but the aqueduct exists there. Many of the journalists in the room really didn't even know it was there. We were intending to build around that and create an environment that can be programmed throughout the year, throughout the time of day, and that it can provide animation and tell stories, and it creates a comfortable scale for those people who want to walk from the library all the way to the event center. Underneath the press canopy, you actually come out onto the Breton Square, which is the very heart and hinge of everything. The Breton Square comes in off of the bay and creates a plaza that can be animated through waterworks and create boardwalks that come out into the Nepean Bay. Allows us to connect to the event center, which you're seeing on the right side, the event center custom design, or of the scope, and creating views into the bay. It can be programmed and, so that we can animate this throughout the year, and by event, race weekend, Earth Day, Blues Fest, and even something like the Senators. The event center is designed like all of the major institutions, the major cultural institutions we have in Ottawa, the National Gallery, the Museum of History across the road, has this view to the river and has a view to Parliament Hill. That's very much in thinking about the event center. So, I'm going to let Eugene finish up. We're all really conscious of the time clock here. This starts. So if we miss something, I'm going to say this. Please come to where the model is, where you can actually talk in detail about it. This is just a snippet and a start of the conversation.
Well, thank you very much.
Créatif ou penseur, architecte, créateur, visionnaires et artistes convergent pour apprendre, perfectionner, concevoir et partager des expériences uniques.
By rail, on foot, you cross the threshold into Illumination Le Breton. At Nations Plaza, you step through a cultural gateway onto the Innovation Promenade. Watch as your young Einstein discovers the joys of science at virtual museums.
Profitez de l'hiver jour et nuit. Devenez spectateurs et acteurs de la scène urbaine. Art public, boutique, divertissement. Vivez l'ambiance festive des cafés-terrasses tout en célébrant la culture locale aux abords de l'aqueduc patrimonial.
Move and be moved by a concert at the World Class Event Center, home to the country's top events. Culture, live music, sports.
La soirée est jeune. Émerveillez-vous devant les couleurs qui embrassent l'eau et le ciel dans un spectacle inoubliable au bassin du Carré Le Breton. Dénichez des trésors dans un marché de nuit couvert. Ouvrez grand votre cœur d'enfant aux merveilles qui vous entourent, des berges jusqu'aux étoiles.
Join cheering crowds pouring out of the championship game or cap your night out on the crown of the event center. At the world's most visited green rooftop outlook and multimedia night walk. Inspired by the Ottawa Gatineau forests, cradle of Canada's history and myth. The skyline shimmers, the future unfolds before your very eyes. A community is reborn and it shines like never before. This is Illumination Le Breton.
Supermarket, and everybody's kind of looking.